Alright, so I'm in the middle of my cutting board project, and I need to use a jointer to get these boards, so they're flat so I can run them through the table saw. Now, these aren't so bad, the hard maple's got a fairly straight edge. I think if this was all I was making the cutting boards out of, then I would just probably run these through the table saw and get a fairly good flat edge. At the end, it's going to be planed off and sanded, so I don't think it's going to be a big deal. But those ironwood boards are really bad, definitely not straight, not even close. There's no way without some kind of jig or without running them through a jointer that I'm going to get a straight edge. Now, I could do the clamping of a straight edge and running my hand saw through technique that you've seen on the internet. But that ironwood is like really, really hard stuff, and so I don't know that my hand saw, my hand power saw, my circular saw, is really going to cut through it very well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up my CNC machine with the biggest bit that I have, and I'm going to joint the boards on the CNC machine. So I'm taking a break from the cutting board project to show you how I use the CNC machine as a jointer. So that is what's going to act as my jointer blade. Basically what I'm going to do is clamp the boards down on the CNC machine, run this thing back in the Y axis without moving the X axis at all, and then I will have a perfectly straight line. A bit, and then we'll run it back and forth. I'm probably going to dig into the table a little bit, but there wasn't really a great way for me to hold this down and change out the pieces without creating some kind of elaborate jig, and I just want to get this project done. So we're just going to clamp it down. We will dig into the table a little bit, and that's okay because this is spoil board. And actually, I'm going to flip this one around because I'd have to take way too much off of this edge to be good. So I'm going to flip this guy. This is actually a good edge. So as soon as that guy is straight, I'm good to go. So, because I didn't move in this direction, this should be a perfectly straight line, but I didn't get all of it touched here, so it's probably not, it probably was not straight this way as well. So I'm going to clamp it back in and do it again until this is gone and looks more like this. More. So what I'm doing is I'm bumping it over in the Y. If you hold control in Mach 3, when you bump, use the arrow keys, it'll only move over one step at a time. Thank you. that should be now a perfectly straight edge, both this way and this way. And I can run through the table saw with a nice perfect edge on the other side. So that's all I really need to get something that's good enough to go through the table saw. We're going to take a board, we're going to take a piece of wood that is uneven, it's twisted, right? And I'm going to show you how to level this off on the CNC machine and make it perfectly flat. So the first thing we need to do is secure the board. Also need to figure out where. Okay, so I've got a high spot here. I mean, these spots are low. The high spots are here and here. So what I need is to hold this end down and put some shims under here so that this side won't move as it's cutting it off. Right. So I need to use some weights on that side. This guy. And what I need is shim that's going to pick this side perfectly flat. That's probably too much. I need to make sure this side doesn't move at all. So I need small. So I need to make sure this side doesn't move. this side's down with the weight. This side, I'm going to get the little shim under here so that this side doesn't move at all. Alright, so now I can take these off. Make sure I'm flat. That should be good. Now what I need is a big giant bit. Happens to be half an inch. Now I'm going to turn on my spindle and I'm going to run this over the entire surface. Take off a little bit just to make it perfectly flat, but I have to touch the entire surface. does make a mess. But could run this through the jointer or the planer again, but I really don't want to get the planer snipe. So now I'm just going to make sure it's flat, and I'm going to do this again on this side. So it's all the way down. This one should be perfectly flat. Perfect.